정신 차려, 정신!
This is Minhyuk, a minor character in Bong Joon-ho's Parasite. He's only in the film for a few scenes, and all he really does is give the main characters a gift, provide them means to be saved from their destitution, and fuck off to a far-off land never to be seen again, only abstractly referred to. So basically, he's... The first time we meet Minhyuk, he's just a booming voice before he descends from on high to visit the Kims. Min is clearly admired by the Kim family and is used as an example for them to aspire to. He gives the family a stone meant to bring them wealth and good fortune before convincing Ki-woo to take the position of tutor at the Park's house. I mean, look at how Ki-woo is lit in the opening scene, a halo already labeling him as Min's chosen one. His first disciple christened, Min then proceeds to disappear from the rest of the film, having gone to study abroad in the United States. Or as I like to put it, he's ascended to the highest realms of the religion of capitalism, where believers are many and gods are abundant. It's worth noting that not all of this is speculation. Bong Joon-ho knows that Min is an interesting character, remarking that Minhyuk is an almost otherworldly character, and he's very important to Ki-woo. Because of this, I needed someone like Park Seo-Joon, who just has a presence about him. In the interestingly greenlit HBO spin-off series, with Bong Joon-ho's involvement, it is speculated that there will be a greater focus on Minhyuk and his relationship with Mrs. Park.
He's a young man, but he's a good guy, and he's a good guy. What more? He's a
good guy, he's a good guy. Are
you in
a church? No, it's not that. I'm a good guy. I'm a good guy. I'm a
good guy. 좋은 분이네.
그죠? 좋죠.
그러네. 좋다.
믿음이 오, 좋은 거야.
The religious subtext doesn't start or stop with Min, though. Early on in the film, we see the Kim family gathered around the dinner table in their lowly sub-level basement apartment.
이게 우리 모처럼들 이렇게 둘러앉아가지고 일부 핸드폰은 그 재개통 그리고
Ki-tek gives a long speech rife with religious language, calling the Wi-Fi connection that they leech off of bounteous. Essentially, it feels like they're saying grace or giving thanks to their capitalist gods. There are several wealthy individuals who are venerated by those less fortunate throughout the film, including Min, and it starts here with the Kims giving thanks for a wealthier neighbor's internet. The logo on the Kims pop cans prominently featured here. The family sort of partakes in a kind of corporate communion, if you will. Interestingly enough, the awkward little toilet shelf in the Kims apartment, from which they access the bounteous Wi-Fi, is actually referred to in the script as a quote-unquote altar. Interesting language, to be sure, but I digress. There are quite a few other moments of dialogue throughout Parasite that are highly evocative of a traditional religious service as well.
Yeah, 이거 진짜 상징적인 거네.
참으로 시의 적절하다. 아, 미디어 신박 사장님께 이 자리를 빌어 감사의 기도를 드리고, 그 민혁이.
They even go so far as to come up with ideas for bracelets.
근데 아까부터 드는 생각인데 민혁이라면 이 상황에서 어떻게 했을까?
But the way I see it, the religious parallels don't just encompass the dialogue. Look at the setting.
사실 이런 집은 아무한테나 보여주는 건 아닌데.
Stairways and basements and a mansion high up on a hill reflect the religious ideas of heaven and hell. But it goes further than that. These up and down journeys reflect the capitalist idea of making it to the top. And the basement, both the Kim's and the hidden one in the Park's house, reflects a sort of capitalist hell, that being poverty. And of course, much like how hell can be and often has been used in Christianity to scare people into staying in the faith, poverty, the fear of the poor, the fear of regression, is used in capitalism to scare people into staying embroiled in the machine. It's imperative for the system that everyone believe in these lies, from the top down. And Parasite shows us examples on either end. The Parks are almost comically afraid of even the slightest leanings toward poverty. Mr. Park's absurd obsession with how it smells comes back to bite him in the end. Meanwhile, Gunsei spends his entire life disturbingly obsessed with Mr. Park, despite the fact that he's stuck in the basement likely because of big businesses like Mr. Park's and the loan sharks that bankrupted his small business. Loan sharks, which of course are not that far off of corporate CEOs.
이렇게 4년 넘게 숨어있는데도 빚쟁이들이 지치지를 않아.
대만 왕수이 카스테라 가게가 망해갖고.
Everyone has bought in, and the hope of rising, and more importantly, the fear of falling any further, keeps them contained to their roles. Even at the end of the film, Ki-woo is still selling the lie. His ultimate goal is still to climb those stairs and reach that peak of wealth.
돈을 벌겠습니다. 아주 많이요.
Everyone in the film remains a devout follower. Mr. Kim asking for Mr. Park's forgiveness.
Park Seo-Joon, 미안하다.
And Ki-woo apostolizing from his place still in the basement apartment and visiting his altar.
아버지는 그냥 계단만 올라오시면 됩니다.
Late one night while watching Columbo, I fell asleep.